Hello, this is Bern, and if you're a single mom who's stepping into the world of dating right now and you're feeling overwhelmed, you're feeling confused, and you don't have much time to waste, on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you four powerful tips that can save you from lots of pain and help you get much more of what you want. So stick around. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great lifetv.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave. On today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you four powerful tips as a single mom that you want to step into when you go dating. Here's the backstory. Today, I have a conversation with a woman who happens to be a single mom and is getting the runaround from someone who is not really kind, but this woman wasn't clearly seeing how this guy is not being kind. Why? Because when he shows up, he's kind and strong and praiseful. But the other part is he doesn't show up a lot of the time. She has problems and he's too busy for her. They have sex, for example, and then maybe he doesn't show up for the next 2 weeks and doesn't text her or call her. That is not kind, even though the emotion when they see each other is kind. What he does after they connect, or what he doesn't do rather, is the last thing but kind. So it got me thinking, I haven't made a single video for single moms out there, and you're some of the dearest human beings to my heart. Why? Because I feel like the world rests on your shoulders sometimes. You're doing everything. You're being the mom and you're also supposed to be the lover and you're supposed to be the dad sometimes if he's not around. And you carry the brunt, the majority of you, of the work of your kids, and it's just not fair sometimes. And I understand. So I want to help you in some small way by sharing four tips with you that can create more freedom in your life. First tip I'm going to share with you is absolutely don't date confused men. Who's a confused man? A guy who doesn't know what he wants. A guy who's ambiguous about what he wants. A guy who's shady about what he wants. A guy who can't to your face tell you what he's looking for. Or a guy who tells you that he's looking for something, but his behavior shows otherwise. In other words, a confused man. Why? Because a guy who has a clear vision for what he wants and he's stepping to the right actions, you can relax. You can be yourself. You can breathe more easily. You don't have to do the work of pursuing. He's doing the pursuing for you. He's not chasing. He's being kind. He's being respectful, but he's pursuing. He's clearly letting you know he wants this. With a guy who's kind of playing games, who's effusive, and he tells you how beautiful you are, and you feel those butterflies in your stomach, but then he forgets about you for weeks on end, or he connects with you and seduces you and even has sex with you, and then he forgets or he can't have time with you when you really need someone to hold you, that's not a cool guy. So no matter how emotionally strong you feel the connection is, no matter how you've told yourself or brainwashed yourself into telling yourself that this is a good guy shows up good in actions. A good guy shows up with powerful, clear intent. You, my dear, have no time to waste. So a guy who connects to a single mom and is just using her for his own self-interest without portraying or offering security and longevity is someone who doesn't deserve to be with you. So be very, very clear on what it is that you're looking for, not necessarily from him in a relationship, and have the courage to ask him what on earth he wants, and then have the courage to tell yourself the truth when he doesn't show up in the way he says. That's tip number one. Tip number two is, you, my dears, have a lot less time than, say, a single woman who is professional like you are, but has no children. That's just the way it works. So that means that you're gonna have less time to go on dates than those women who don't have kids, most times. So because of that, you only have a certain number of spots each week. Sometimes you may have one spot for one date a week, or maybe two if you're pushing it hard. So you want to be more upfront and you want to understand who you're dating a little bit better than someone who has the luxury of more time. So something simple you can do is if you agree to go on a date and you're not 100% clear that this sounds really cool to you, then set a filtering system where you have, for example, a phone conversation, or even better, set up a new Skype account with a different name so they don't know who you are, different Skype account, and have a Skype conversation with them where you can feel some of the chemistry, some of the intensity, some of the way he's showing up. And if he passes that filter, then go on and have a date. If he doesn't, and you spent 10 minutes setting the whole thing up versus 2 hours basically on the date, or an hour and a half was half an hour together. So 3 hours of your week wasted unnecessarily. Sometimes you'll see someone who looks 20 years older than the pictures he showed you. Guess what? If you don't feel like this guy is being honest, you don't have a date with him. Sometimes you'll feel strong chemistry. Guess what happens? You show up even stronger to that date. It's a win-win situation. Most guys should be able to understand that you want to have a short conversation with them before you go on a date. Have that conversation, ideally see them. You'll feel a lot more than if you just have that conversation. And then you'll be able to have a clear idea as to who you're investing your time in. And that way you can eliminate some contenders from the pool and have more time for yourself and for your life and for your children. The third tip that I have for you is probably super clear to you, but you'd be surprised how many women don't necessarily get this. Wait longer. And longer means longer than you usually do to introduce your kids to this man. Why? Because it's a big deal. Because it's a role model for your kids. Because their hearts are going to be involved. Because you don't want to be saying, well, here's the guy for the week or the guy for the month. So take some time to know him. Spend a few months getting to know each other. If it becomes exclusive at that point, you start bringing up the possibility of introduction, but take your time. Do not be pressured into family merging before you're ready. Do not be pressured into family merging before exclusivity. And even within exclusivity, give it some time so that there's more solidity to the whole thing. You can eliminate a few guys that your kids will never have to know as a result of waiting longer. Fourth one, and I can't emphasize it strongly enough, the guy who is with you should be so freaking lucky to be with you and your kids. I know that sometimes to you, my dear, it breaks my heart when I feel it. It feels like almost like it's a burden for the guy to actually want you despite your kids. And I mean, unless your kids are horrible brats and they're really like they have no manners, the guy should be so lucky to be part of your family's life. So look for a man who wants to be with you, not despite your kids, but because of them as well. Look for someone who's looking for to be a man and a role model for your family in a way that is inclusive, embracing of them versus, I guess I have to put up with it. That's not a cool deal for you, and that's not a guy that is going to sustain the test of time with the inevitable ups and downs that come with being a mom. Hope, my dear, that this is helpful to you in some way. Hope that you get this. My heart goes out to you because I can feel from at least my clients who are single moms and the many, many women I've connected with throughout my life who reach out for help who are single moms. I have my deepest admiration for you. You can definitely do this. This is possible to do. You just have to be more mindful in how you do it and show up with sometimes stronger filters to avoid wasting time. So hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful to you in some way. If it is, I'm going to ask you to do three things. My number one, click like on this video or thumbs up. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Number three, on the first line of the description of this video, you're going to find a link that will take you to a masterclass on how you can create the relationship you want with a lot less pain and much more excitement than your current trajectory. Underneath that link, you'll find, if you say, you know what, Bern, I save me the videos, I've been working too hard and I want specific help from someone, in this case you, to help me to find this relationship, and you want to reach out to see if we can be a fit to work together, then there's a link for that as well. You can reach out and we're fit. Fill an application. If we are fit, then we'll do it. And if not, then you can still benefit from the free videos and all the stuff that I'm sharing with you here. My love goes out to you and hope you have an amazing week. And as always, I challenge you, live a full and a conscious life.